Welcome everybody. This video is going to be the quick set lock that we featured in one of the first videos I did, and then I started to make it into a challenge lock, and I uploaded the video yesterday or the day before with all the completed pins, top and bottom, all homemade. They're all pinned up in this lock. I'm going to try and pick it on camera. I'm going to give it a shot. The key itself, you could definitely feel it getting caught up when you stick it in. The threading in the chamber is definitely grabbing onto those homemade key pins, and the driver pins that fall down in there too, so it's like trying to pull it out, it'll come out, but you can, it's, they're caught on the threads. Kind of gotta turn it and then wiggle it out. Keep doing that. There we go. So, we'll do a pick and gut. If I get it open, we'll do a gutting in this video. All in one take. I think it's going to be a lot harder just in general with all that. I'm not sure. We're going to give it a try though. I'm going to gut it. I'm going to use still have the keyway, my 50,000 pry bar from Peterson. And I'm going to use my regular hook, my short hook from Peterson. I'm not gonna use my divorced or my offset diamond or hook diamond, whatever Peterson calls it. Alright, let's start. Back of the lock. I hope you can hear all this clicking, because there's gonna be a lot of feedback from all that threading. Something, getting some feedback. Got some counter rotation there. All right, let me think. I need to see. I know I made it, but I still don't remember where I put everything, because in the video I did last night, after I showed the pins in the video, I put the lock together and I forgot to put the retaining clip on the back, put the key in, and then I turned it to make sure it would work. That was the first time I actually put it together. I had tried all the pins individually in one chamber, but all five together, I was just still worried about it. And I yanked the key out and the core came right out. And the key pin stayed in. Obviously, they were going to go back in order anyway. They have to, they don't have to, but I wanted to use a key with it just in case it doesn't ever get open. And, oh my god, this is tough. But, the top driver pin got switched around a little bit. And even if I know what's where, with all this threading, it's the first time I've ever picked a lock with threading. So if I get this, I'll be happy. Don't think I'm going to get it. I'm not breaking my pick over it. Kind of, I don't know if I'll be disappointed or happy if I got it, because I don't know if I got it, if that means that it turned out. Let me zoom out. I don't know how well you can see. Just because if I get it, then I don't know how good of a challenge it really was, or if it just means that I am getting better. Jeez, man, I'm in a deep full set. I think I must have got one of those spools. I made some deep spools last night. Just about as deep as I can make it before it got too thin and it would start to bend on me. And oh, what was that? Alright, and some more movement. It's like everything feels like it's definitely ain't open. I know that. Oh, what's this? Getting some feedback. I'm getting counter rotation, but okay, that key pin's springy. This one back here is definitely the roadblock. I'm gonna actually go ahead and put my Peterson gem. Oh my god, where is my Peterson gem? Right here. Maybe I can get a little bit more force up with that. Because it's not as hooked, so it won't... Look at my core when I push up on this. See my tension wrench coming back? Oop, there we go. Coming back the other way. I definitely got feedback there. Oop. Alright, come on. Alright, let's get this. Oh, man. Come on. We're in a deep, 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 deep falsetto. That's turning. Whew. Oh, I thought I had it. That must be the second deep falsetto, because it turned. I feel like it went a little more. I mean, look at that falsetto. I mean, that's straight up and down. We got a huge gap, so I think we're hopefully getting close. Let's see, with that deep-ass falsetto, makes it hard to... It's like, what do I need to do? Let me come out of that. There we go. Oh my goodness, guys, this is tough. I have confidence, though. I don't like that sound. I know I'm gonna break a pig doing this, I just feel it. I wonder if I try and use my the sparrow's hook with that little dimple, but this is such a weak pick. I'm gonna bend it upwards. Yep, I don't like that sound. Let me lighten up on my tension a little bit. Oh, there we go. This is only 5 pins also, so I couldn't imagine if this was like a 6 pin, 7 pin. Oh, what's that? What do we got? Sounded like one of the serrated. Ooh, what do we got going on? Oh my god. We did it. We fucking... I'm sorry for cussing, but we got that. Alright, let's gut it. I'm gonna leave it in the... Oh man. I can't believe I got that. That's a good feeling. Now, I don't know if that means I'm getting better, or I just didn't do a good job making a challenge lock, but with the pins I put in there, and that threading, the way it's getting caught up, I'm hoping it's the first. Alright, we got my tool out. Let the zoom out a little bit. Get this gutted, and you'll see the pins again. The same pins in the video yesterday. Do this all in one fell swoop. Wow, I can't believe we got that, boys. That's some good shit. Alright, trying to keep this in frame. It was definitely tougher than I thought. It took probably a good 5-6 minutes, and that was just 5 pins, and I got that quick set keyway, which gives me that advantage because there's this little shelf on the side here, but still, that's threading. And I feel like, see, I know when I'm getting certain feedback from what type of security pin and whatnot, but I definitely could tell when I was in the 2 deep false spools, obviously. But then that last serration one, I just knew it had to be one of the serrated pins. I can't even remember what I all made, but alright, that's what's up. So let's go ahead and gut this. I need a shim before I do that, actually. Because of all the cuts and stuff, I had a hard time last night. Go ahead and still in the unlocked position. Just stick my shin. It's hard to get it to go straight in. There we go. Alright, let's go ahead and... Alright, so... Because normally I wouldn't have anything special to show you. Where the, I'm gonna turn the flash on. So, if you watch the video, then you already know I'm gonna make sure that this stays in view. I can just do this. So you already know that these chambers are threaded. One, two, three, four, five are all threaded. So let's see what kind of key pins we got in here. Even though I have a memory idea. Alright, we're gonna start with key pin one. I wanna keep this in focus. So that's, I can say that's in the video the whole time. Alright, key pin one. That's right, I remember this one. So there is. So here is the first homemade key pin with a threaded chamber, obviously. I'm gonna move that up here. Come on. Alright. Here goes number two. I remember this one. Oh no! That sucks. Oh, found it. I found it. Don't you worry. Don't have to redo this video, thank God. Let me try that one more time, just more pressure. Alright. There's key pin two. These are all key pins still. Key pin three. Ooh, yeah. So here goes key pin three. Sorry. Key pin three. Was this one. And if you didn't watch the video, then these are new to you, but here's what was in the third key pin. Again, third chamber. All of them on. This one's having difficulty. Look at that. It's caught. Well, you can't. It's hard to see. I'm hanging it upside down, and if I can zoom in or bring it up close enough, it's caught on the. Damn, it's hard to make straight in the. It's caught on the threading, and that's why it's just chilling like that. That's pretty cool. The other key pin was trying to come out. Look at that. There we go. That makes sense. Look at that. That's, I don't even remember making this one. Just a key pin with a nice deep cut. Just one deep serration in it. And last but not least. Oh yeah, this is the one I, how did I have that in there? I don't remember. I think I had it in there. I had it in there serration side down, that's right, because that would have had the more chances of getting caught. Even though the spool was getting caught, I wanted more chances because then the spool would also help give me a spool, you know, false or counter rotation and all that stuff. So that was, this is actually a regular serrated pin that I just made the same length as the key, proper key pin, and just stuck it in there, and then I spooled out the top part of it. All right, and we'll do another quick shot of the core so you can see the threads better. Boom, all threaded on each, all the way around, not like some half thread, I don't know if there is such thing, but. That would be kind of interesting, but alright. So, let's get to the good stuff. Well, it's all good shit, especially number three. Whoever gave me that idea on Reddit to say go ahead and attack that, I'm glad I listened. Where's my, oh, duh, we got the shimmin. alright, driver pin one is that really nice, deep, deep spool, just the spool, and I just made it really deep. That's why I was getting all that deep falsettes on the video, which you could clearly see. The springs, I know they're just regular steel little springs, nothing special. I'll show them. They're all the same though, nothing fancy. All right number two, driver pin two. This one was in here like so. The serration side on the bottom, the normal serrateds, the where you can see a couple grooves. That was, you know, on the bottom like it normally is. And then I just sport it out a little bit in the middle. And then it's got a deep, not a deep deep, but another extra serration up here towards the top of my fingernail. So that was kind of an interesting pen. So that was number two. And like I said, the springs, I don't know if you want me to show you them all. They're all the same. Wow, I still can't believe I got that. But I'm having a hard time. I pick my American locks all the time, and now that I need to do it on camera to get my blue belt, I can't get it. I can't get my 1100 or my 52, and I don't know, that it doesn't say 53 on Reddit's site, but I know I'm a blue belt. I don't, maybe a purple, I don't know. I don't have any of those locks, so I need to know something equivalent. Oh, excuse me. This is number driver pin 3. This is my other deep spool. Pretty much like the first one, just it's just a little bit shorter. So, not as long. So, definitely get different feedback. And, again, a regular spring. My favorite, I think, I don't know if this is my favorite. I have two favorite driver pins that I make that I'm going to continuously try to make, because I think I figured out a good way to constantly get them to be almost identical. This is what I call the candlestick. It was a serrated pin, and now it's like a double spool with a shelf in the middle. And that shelf, you know, once you get into the spool effect, then that shelf is going to lean up into the threading, and it's a nightmare. That probably played a good part in this lock. That was probably lock. I probably won't get it again if I tried. Oh, okay. Well, the other key pin came out, but that's fine. Or driver pin, because that's the last one anyway. This is the other one that I was really excited about. And the other spring just popped out, so I'm going to hold this, put the spring where it goes. And then this is the other one. This is the brother to the candlestick, as I call it. And it's funny because this is exactly what key pin... This is the exact same idea as the key pin it's sitting on, but I had made this first, and it's just a serrated pin as normal with the spool on top, and I keep the spool side or the serrated side down, and like I said, because it'll catch up more, and then it'll still give you that, you know, this way instead of having it the other way. I feel like it would definitely catch up on the threading, but I don't think the serrations would get too much action, so I feel having it go straight down like this in the chamber is the better way. And that's it. Nothing else. Did it all in one take. I'm very shocked I got that. Trying to do a close up for the maybe I'll try and make this the thumbnail. If I can make it straight without spilling it. And there we go. You know what, let's do this for the thumbnail. Thanks for watching. I see a few people have subscribed. Thank you for that. My first giveaway, I said I'm going to do a giveaway. I'm going to do it at 15 subscribers. 15 is a good number. So 10 more subscribers. And I have a master. I have a few giveaways planned already. I'm anxious to do them all just to be able to give back. But I think it's kind of a fun idea. But I'll let you know when, or well, obviously as soon as I get 15, I'm going to do it as soon as I get 15 subscribers, and I'll show you the lock in this video. And so it's only 10 more. I'm not like expecting a lot, but I want to give a few more people the chance. You know, if there's only 3, it's just no problem. It's just I figured it'd be a little funner that way. And then the people who didn't win something will have a chance to win something next time, because I have, after this giveaway, my next one's at least 3 or 4. They're all the same lock, but I'm going to obviously give 1 to 4 different people. And it's a pretty decent lock. I'll explain that when I try and pick that. I might make that video next. So, I'm trying to just give you an idea. Okay, actually, you know what? We'll do it like this. We'll take it off, tripod again, wrap this video up. So, like I said, subscribe. If you like this content, drop a like. If you like the video, any questions, comments, anything you want to see, need help with, any advice from me, leave it in the comments, let me know. And that is what we just picked in the quick set. That ain't gonna help, but quick set keyway with threaded chambers. Can't believe I got that. Thanks for watching. Oh, and this is the Master Lock right here hanging on my shelf. The one dead in the middle with the black lettering. We did a video where I had it brand new. I picked it. I was talking about how it's a good beginner lock. Ended up gutting it. And I gutted it, or repinned it with a spool, a serrated, and then a serrated spool and left one plain. I think that's a great start for a beginner when they're getting into security pins. So technically three of the four are only security pins. I think it would be a good first giveaway. I'll pay for the shipping to wherever it's going. You don't got to pay nothing. You just got to, whenever I say that we're going to do the drawing, I'm going to just do a random drawing. And I'll have everybody comment probably like Master Lock M530 or just M530. If you comment M530, I know you want to be entered. I'll keep it open for 24 hours. After that, I'll take all the names on the comments, throw them into a, write them down on paper, throw them into something I can't see, record the video, pull it out, and then you'll have 24 hours or so to contact me, maybe like 3 days. Because if not, then I would like to give it to somebody else, you know, if they don't reply back. But I'll pay for shipping. So, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And there's the challenge. Like, can't believe I got it open. I definitely want to send it out to somebody. I already know who I'm going to send it out to first. Depending on how long he has it, I will definitely get it out to somebody else after that. Thanks for watching, guys.